guys, this is the Satan Escape here. We're going to be checking out bite-sized metal slugs X. I, the Sega Kid, am going to be hosting bite-sized Metal Slug X. You know, originally I was only playing games that were like on Sega systems, and then I said, you know what, this game isn't even on the Sega system. It gives. And then it was kind of, you know, explained, it kind of sinks in that Sega doesn't have like, you know, a dedicated console anymore. And that's really disappointing, because I was always all about Sega, because Sega is one of the greatest companies in the world. I absolutely love Sega, and I still think they're one of the greatest companies in the world. But you know what? They just don't even have a system anymore. So they gotta, they even put their games on Nintendo systems. Can you believe that? I was always all about Nintendo stuff, and you know, maybe Nintendo does stuff, but I am willing to give them a chance, because if Sega's willing to give them a chance, and maybe I can give them a chance too, you know? Because it has actually been a long time since King Kabuto picked me up and took me to the future. It's been since 1995, and that's like over 20 years ago. So, you know, a lot has changed since then, and I guess Nintendo did win the console war. They must have cheated. I accept that they cheated. But, you know, even if they did cheat, they still won, and it really sucks, but that's just the reality that we live in today. And it's not even Nintendo that's on top anymore. No, Nintendo's still there, they're still making their stuff, but it's all about like these bigger companies. Microsoft, I guess that's insane. Microsoft and Sony. I would never have imagined that back in 1995. Even though I think I heard there was some rumor somewhere. I heard some guy at school talking about Nintendo and Sony teaming up or something. It's like a rumor that he's heard. He knew somebody that was like, you know, high up at Nintendo, and we didn't believe him. And, you know, we still might. He's probably lying, man. He's probably a liar. And we all call him a liar. And I'm sure he's still lying today. I'm sure he's lying all over the place. But you know what? That's okay. He's probably in jail for saying bad things about Sega. And that's where he belongs. That's what all people that say bad things about Sega, they belong in jail. And, you know, one day when I'm like, you know, the king of the world, I'm going to make sure that happens. But until that day, we're going to fight these helicopters. And that's going to be awesome. I just love playing video games so much. It's one of my favorite things. You know, my mom says I play way too many video games, but I don't think so. My mom, she's crazy, man. She says I should be, like, hanging out with people more. And that's fine. Like, I do spend some time with friends. We play video games all the time, me and my friends. And sometimes, like, we even play outside. Or maybe once in a while, but not like video games. Oh, you know what? This section right here, this is, like, one of the most annoying sections in the game. Like, I played this game a couple times before I recorded it for you. And, like, just trying to get all these subway cars, super annoying. Oh, gotta get that pig. I wanna get that pig. Oh, I was off the screen. Whatever. We'll give you some points, but if you eat too much, your character will actually get fat. And that's really, really funny. I love making my character go fat. Like, if I had to pay for the stories and the credits, I might not want that, because that makes your character a lot kind of weaker and more vulnerable. It doesn't really add anything, but it's a funny little visual effect, and it's funny. And, like, but, you know, I got unlimited quarters here, so it doesn't even matter. I can make my character as fat as I want, or make it weaker, but I don't have to pay any quarters. So, you know, it's kind of better to do that, especially since you're recording it, because you want to show your character getting fat and all that. But I haven't really done that yet. But, you know what, that's something I'll do this level and next level. I'm sure you'll see that pretty soon. It's going to be really cool. Even if it didn't happen, like, I know it happened when King Kabuto was playing. I watched his videos, and his character got really fat, and, like, just started running around, and then the character literally, once he gets hit, his fat explodes all over the place. And it's like something out of a horror movie or something, or an action movie, and it's, like, really, really funny. Yeah, it's really cool. And now we get to, like, just shoot these huge tanks. This isn't just any normal tank. Okay, a normal tank would have, like, half of that. And now it's got, like, added, like, you know, a grill in the front. It's got, like, added cannons. It's got more tires. There's tracks. This is calling tires. I don't know. And finally, it's got hyper machine gun. Oh, like, okay, now I gotta fight more of these trains. These trains are meant to kill you.
yeah.
This Elfie is feeling pretty good this time. Last couple times, you know, like, I would fight these trains and they just crush me. But there's a couple more, so that it gets actually, it does get quite a bit harder as you go on. Let's check this out. Now you gotta fight all these guys. They're coming at you. As soon as you stop shooting at the train goes faster, and then you just get stuck. That's the way it goes in Metal Slug sometimes, you know, because this was an arcade game, and arcade games are made to make money. That's something even I realized when I would play the arcade games, like, these are not exactly fair. They're meant to eat your quarters. You're meant to die. You're meant to die a lot. You know, like, maybe if you're some sort of grandmaster and you spent, like, hundreds and hundreds of dollars, you can kind of get past the levels without, you know, spending any quarters, if you're so good at it. Maybe. But, you know, it would take a lot of practice. You have to know what to do at every single step. And by the time you've got that thing memorized so much, what's the point? It's like you've already played through it so many times, you might as well play another game. There's probably another Metal Slug game in the same arcade, maybe. Or, you know, maybe something different, something else. So it's like, you want to keep on playing different kinds of games too. So you don't have unlimited money, you don't have unlimited time, just keep on mastering one Metal Slug game and there's so many other games to play. But just, that's not to say that Metal Slug isn't worth it, but it is freaking awesome. Just look at these guys. Look at these animations. Oh, that guy just blew up. His guts were just splattered all over the place, and my character got destroyed. Oh, I just would have just put in another quarter, but of course, I don't have to do that. But I love the way those guys just explode. This game is actually super gory. It's like Splatterhouse. Have you ever played Splatterhouse? And I had that on the Genesis. It was like the coolest game. Like, it was so hardcore. Until my mom took it away because she thought it was too violent. But then I found it. She was keeping it in her, like, drawer in her bedroom with, like, all these underwear stuff in it. And there was, like, a bottom, and I just, you know, I didn't care. I just wanted to play Splatterhouse. So I took it. I took it and I started playing it. And then I put it back in my mom's underwear drawer. And then she didn't even know I took it. So every day, when she leaves, I just go in her underwear drawer. And I take Splatterhouse and I play it. Until one day I found it, and then one day it was gone. And I don't know where she put it. I think she might have given it to somebody because I went to Uncle Tony's house, and he had a copy of Splatterhouse. And I asked him where he got it, but he wouldn't tell me. So I think Uncle Tony now has my copy of Splatterhouse, although that was over 20 years ago. Well, I think maybe what I gotta do, I gotta go find Uncle Tony and get my Splatterhouse back. That's what I'm gonna get King Kabooba also to try to find my Uncle Tony. So I can get Splatterhouse. That's gotta be a priority. And now we fight the newest and most awesome boss here. It's like this giant sub that shoots all these plasma electrical balls at you. And it's crazy fun. And it's so awesome. And you get to use that next suit. It's not like a Metal Gear, but it's like a Metal Gear. I mean, Metal Slug. It's not a Metal Slug. But like, it's still really cool. It's like something out of the Alien movie. I even watched the Alien movie when I was young. My mom didn't know that I watched it. I watched it over at my friend Jerry's house. And, you know, I couldn't sleep for a week. So I couldn't tell my mom because I watched the Alien movie, but she didn't let me watch it. So I told her that I couldn't sleep because somebody at school beat me up. And then I had to tell her who it was, but I wasn't sure. So I just told her that it was Jake. Jake's always kind of a bully to me anyway. So my mom called the school board, and now Jake is suspended. So that's pretty cool. I get to go to school. Not anymore, of course, but back then I would go to school, and Jake wasn't even there. Because he was suspended for beating me up, but he didn't beat me up. But don't tell anybody that. I just couldn't admit that I couldn't sleep because I watched the Alien movie, because I would have got in trouble. I wasn't supposed to watch that movie. I asked my mom like 50 times and she would say, no, you're going to have nightmares. And then I had nightmares. Mission complete.